Why is Star Citizen performance so bad? It's a question that people have been asking for a long time, but we have a pretty clear answer from one of the CRG devs on Spectrum. So let's get into it. It's pretty interesting. So on Spectrum, in the Ask the Dev section, somebody asked how many CPU cores and threads does the game currently use and how many will it plan? How many are they planning for it to use in the future? And this is the response. And this gives us information that we've kind of been guessing at and CRG have never really completely confirmed. There's been a lot of speculation about why performance is so poor. A lot of people often just say, oh, it's just down to the servers. And that isn't true in terms of what we're looking at here. There are issues with the servers and there are issues that they bring up, like desync and things like that. But that isn't the core issue of why client-side FPS is so low. And that's what this is going to explain to us. This is going to get quite technical in parts, but hopefully it will be followable, if that's even a word. It's not. But anyway, let's look at this now. So as of now, we're already utilizing all cores on your machine, is what they're saying. Yeah, we know that it's not a single threaded game or even it's not restricted for. It will spread the load of Star Citizen across your whole CPU. However, there are two threads, the main thread and the render thread, which have very high utilization depending on where you are in the game. In draw call heavy scenes like Lawville, New Babbage, etc., the game is mostly bottlenecked by the render thread. This is quite a big deal breaker at the moment and is the major reason why the game is so slow in big locations and why maxed out single thread performance is still so important for Star Citizen. And yes, we can confirm that. We've done a load of testing into that. In the cities, you are not bottlenecked by your GPU, despite this obviously being at lower frames, but yeah, your bottleneck is the CPU single threaded performance, which is why when I tested my 5900X versus my old 3700X, the massive increase in IPC in performance between the generations of those two Ryzen processors meant that you get a lot better performance with the Ryzen 5000 series. And it's the same on Intel side, the newer, the quicker single thread performance, the better you get in the cities. So that explains that. And yeah, we've seen that ourselves. And yeah, people often kind of look at sizes and they think, well, my CPU isn't maxed out and my GPU isn't maxed out. What's going on? But what's happening is that the one thread that is running or the rendering, so the render thread, my understanding would be that that is telling the GPU what to do and it's basically queuing everything up. But it's so bottlenecked that even though the CPU doesn't look like it's being utilized at 100%, that one thread is maxed out. And as we go on here, they'll explain how that's going to change. So Gen 12, along with Vulcan, will improve this massively. Interesting, I hadn't really understood that their Gen 12 renderer is not the same as their Vulcan implementation. They are separate things, so this is quite interesting. The first step will be the new Gen 12 renderer, which will already improve performance by a big margin due to improved render thread performance. So that's really good. That sounds like it's coming quite relatively soon. For Star Citizen, at least. So starting with 3.14, we'll be slowly rolling out parts of the Gen 12. However, you will see the big performance improvement only once everything is fully transitioned, specifically once we enable the Gen 12 scene rendering. So that sounds as though it's not going to be, that won't be in 3.14, but it could be 3.15, it could be 3.16. Let's hope it's 3.16 is probably more realistic. So in parallel, we are working on the Vulcan backend, so different, which comes along quite nicely as well. It's to be expected that we can roll out Vulcan shortly after the full Gen 12 renderer is working. So again, we may be looking at let's say this. It's very unlikely to be 3.15, but maybe we're talking 3.16 or we don't even know if we're going up to 3.17. Pyro is coming at some point. We assume that's when it's going to move to 4.0, but anyway. Once that is done, we'll push into paralyzing the whole scene rendering even more and get rid of the entire render thread. And my understanding of what that would mean is that rather than when they're moving to the Gen 12 renderer, they're going to improve the render thread performance, but paralyzing it will mean that rather than it running in one render thread, as I said, they get rid of the entire render thread, it then will be able to be split across your CPU and it will be able to, different cores or threads on your CPU will be able to be working away and send stuff to the GPU. That's my very, very basic understanding of what that means. When this is done, the rendering will be utilized across all available cores as much as it can, and we should no longer be bottlenecked by the rendering. So there we go. That's quite technical, but if you wanted the short version that was not that technical, in the next few patches, let's say by the end of the year, to be let's use good Star Citizen time, which means it's never as soon as you think it's going to be. We're probably by the end of the year, we look like we're actually going to get a decent performance improvement in the big cities, and that is great news for everybody. So, I mean, I've done a load of testing with a 3080 and a 5900X, and I'll pop that on the screen now. You can see that performance is okay, but it's not what you'd expect from that hardware compared to most modern games. And really, this is a huge deal in terms of how Star Citizen progresses over the next few years. If they can improve performance, if they can get rid of this bottleneck, which is what they're saying they are going to do, and they seem very confident again, then the game changes massively. How it performs will be, should be, a big, big difference. So, whereas at the moment you're happy to get 35 FPS in something like Lawville, but let's hope that can be hitting more like 60. Who knows? We don't know how much this will perform, will improve performance. That's, we're guessing if we say we do, but. Yeah, it should be good, and it should also mean, what I'm probably more interested in really is what this will mean for lower end machines, because obviously PC parts are crazy at the moment. There's no way to buy half of them, and when you do get one that's on sale, it's crazily overpriced. The CPUs are overpriced still, really, and the GPUs are crazy because of all sorts of factors. But this should mean that you won't need an absolute mental system to run the game. So let's hope that this really opens up lower end machines, and it really opens up CPUs that are, at the moment, you have to say you need a six core, really you need a six core CPU with as much single thread performance as you can, which really rules out the majority of the PCs that people own. Most CPUs are not in that boat. That, if you're looking at an older i7 even from Intel, maybe before they started increasing the core counts of them, they don't really run the game very well at all. But after this change, after these changes, there's a good chance that the minimum spec of the game will be a bit more realistic. Whereas at the moment, the minimum spec of the game can be close to, a 5900X, isn't it? Well, not 5600X. Will get you decent performance everywhere you go. But yeah, there's a load of thoughts. It's interesting, it's hopeful, there's hope here finally for decent performance, and the too long didn't understand what on earth you're saying that is that with the Gen 12 and the Vulcan stuff that they're doing, there is finally hope that our performance will improve in places like the big cities at least. If you like this, subscribe, give it a thumbs up as well, and come and follow me on Twitch, where when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot. See you soon, bye.